Carshalton, I've got this one. Take the night off. Welcome, my dear, do pop in your bonny thing, you. You're probably nervous, I'm sure I would be too if I were you. Choose a seat, how's about one by the hearth? I'm treating you this evening, I've even had my weekly bath a day early. Oh yes, I'm spruced to the nines. You young lady are in for a crackin' ruddy good time. I've a bloody good mind, 2 pints on you now. When I see them bouncing around as you flounce in your gown, I'm counting down now to when we really go to town. I apologise, but you'd rather have a chap mopping his brow. I'm a gentleman first, but I've been a little parched. You're quenching my thirst and you've rather stiffened my starch. I approach, but I find that my attention is drawn to the welcome mat, where lies the paper with the test score. I'd best pour a juice or more, but the desire is gone. Now I just want to know who's batting at number one.
Rule Britannia,
I'll make love to you, but once I've read the paper. I'll make love to you, but once I've read the papers. She purred, my darling dear, I'm ready for you now. I said, blast it to high heaven, we're 4 wickets down. As she seductively unbuttoned her dress and slid the thing off, I balked at the 2 catches that silly made off. She got rid of all of her garmentry and professed a wish to do harm to me. I looked upon her with alarm to see, but I wasn't averse to her charms. But the colonials had rather got us over the barrel. This didn't mean I didn't appreciate that this filly had dropped her a paddle. So I mustered some gusto to get her flustered, and just so, my trusted thrust I know can make a lady combust. So where's my mind? Let go of the cricketing woes. I remember the bet I had on the 3-10 at Chepstow. My dear, I assure you I can go on for ages. But first, do you mind if I have a quick look at the racing pages? As I search for my filly, not human equine, said human filly started imparting some favourite curse words of mine.
Rule Britannia,
I'll make love to you, but once I've read the paper. I'll make love to you in a moment or two. My dear, please don't leave me lonely. Come over here, at least trombone me. Oh, that's the spirit. Glove, said, now I'll show you how an Englishman makes love. A fair dived upon the bed, but also sadly on her shin. As I rolled to one side, she squealed, you're pinching my skin. She cried, get off my hair. I said, but it's wet over there. I could have been better prepared rather than sweating and scared. She said, how's this, my love? I yelled, stop it, it's bending. I'm afraid this tale of romance had no happy ending.